Welcome to a lesson on the properties of parallel lines. The goals are to define the different types of angles formed by a transversal and parallel lines, as well as how they relate. And then we'll state the corresponding angle postulate, which will be the basis for proving many of the properties of parallel lines. In the previous video, we defined the different types of angles formed when a transversal cuts two lines. We'll go ahead and review that as well as state how they relate to one another. Vertical angles are non-adjacent angles formed by two intersecting lines, and we know from before that these angles are congruent. So angle 1 and 4 are vertical angles and congruent. So are 2 and 3, 5 and 8, and 6 and 7. These are vertical angles, and they are also congruent angles. Corresponding angles are two angles in the same position with respect to the transversal, but on a different line. And these angles are also congruent. So if we view angle 1 as being in the upper left-hand corner of the intersection of the transversal and the first black line, angle 5 is also in the upper left-hand corner of the intersection of the transversal in red and the second black line. These are corresponding angles, and they are also congruent angles, as well as angle 3 and angle 7, angle 2 and angle 6, as well as angle 4 and angle 8. These are corresponding angles, and they're also congruent angles. Alternate interior angles are two angles on the interior but opposite side of the transversal. Interior angles are the angles between the two parallel lines. Therefore, the alternate interior angles will be angle 3 and angle 6, as well as angle 4 and angle 5. And again, these angles are congruent. Next, we have the alternate exterior angles. Two angles on the exterior, but on the opposite side of the transversal. So angle 1 and angle 8 are alternate exterior angles, which are congruent, as well as angle 2 and angle 7. And for the last two, we have consecutive interior angles, or same side interior angles. These are two angles on the interior and on the same side of the transversal, and these angles are supplementary. Remember, supplementary angles have a sum of 180 degrees. So angle 4 and angle 6 are consecutive interior angles, as well as angle 3 and angle 5, and these angles are supplementary. And then lastly, we have the consecutive exterior angles, or same side exterior angles. Two angles on the exterior, but on the same side of the transversal, and once again, these angles are supplementary. So angle 2 and angle 8 are same side exterior angles, which are supplementary, as well as angle 1 and angle 7. Remember, the relationships stated in red are only true if the two lines intersected by the transversal are parallel lines. Let's take a look at a Wolfram demonstration just to reinforce this idea. So again, here we see vertical angles in blue, red, orange, and purple. Notice, regardless of how the transversal cuts the two parallel lines, the angles remain congruent or equal in measure. Now we see the corresponding angles in red, blue, purple, and orange. And notice that the corresponding angles are congruent regardless of how the transversal intersects the two lines. Consecutive or same side interior angles in red and in blue, notice these are supplementary, not congruent. Again, regardless of how the transversal cuts the two parallel lines. Next, we have the same side exterior or consecutive exterior angles in red and in blue. Again, these are supplementary. The alternate interior angles, again, in blue and red, notice that these are congruent. And then lastly, we have the alternate exterior angles. Again, notice they are congruent. Now we're going to prove many of these in the next several videos, but in order to prove these, we have to first state the corresponding angle postulate. A postulate is not proved but it is assumed to be true because it is self-evident. So we're going to use this postulate in the next several videos to prove many of the relationships that we previously stated. And here's the corresponding angle postulate. It states that if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, the corresponding angles are congruent. So we accept this to be true without a proof. So that means angle 1 is congruent to angle 5, angle 2 is congruent to angle 6, angle 3 is congruent to angle 7, and angle 4 is congruent to angle 8. And hopefully this does make sense. If these two parallel lines are slanted in the same direction, then if a line was to cut those two, the corresponding angles that would be formed would be congruent. We'll go ahead and stop here. I hope you found this helpful.